Okay, it's the weekend, S&S Turbines. We're in the back lot, and it's a bit windy, but I thought I'd show you our cutaway, our display. It's been here for quite some time. We're looking in the front of a LM1500. Actually, this has got the parts from both, but it's actually made up as a J79. It's missing the nose bullet fairing, which we've recently been looking at. That's the front frame. The IGVs, the VIGVs, they're variable in angle. And let's look at the cutaway here. These are the actuating rings for the VIGVs. There's the first stage of the compressor. Look at that, it all moves. That's the actuating ring for the first stage of the variable stator vanes. Second stage of the compressor. Second stage stators, three. And down the line, four, five, six. And stage seven stators are not variable. This is what it looked like. The air heads through there, each stage compressing by about 1.1:1 ratio till we get to the outlet guide vanes, and they direct the air straight into the diffuser, the midframe, the diffuser, which contains the fuel nozzles. These are liquid fuel nozzles. They inject fuel directly into the combustor cans. Let's go back a bit. This is the mixing air holes for cooling air to mix with the flames. And these are the interconnectors, or the ears, or the crossfire tubes. They allow the flame to travel between the combustors that have igniter plugs and the other ones. Out of 10 combustors, only 2 of them have spark plugs or igniter plugs. So the interconnectors is how the fire gets all the way around. For ignition, once it's lit, it stays lit. And here, this is the transition duct, which we've also seen before. Turns the cylindrical outlet of the 10 combustors into an annular ring of hot gases. This is the nozzle that forces the gases in this direction, hitting the first stage of the turbine, causing it to turn. That sound you hear is dirt trapped in the cases hitting the ends of the compressor blades. It's quite musical. The reason they're musical is because they're seized solid in the discs. Otherwise they'd be a little bit deader sounding. Listen to that. Okay, now back to the... This is the second stage nozzle. It's hard to see, but it's very similar to the first stage. It redirects the exhausts from the first stage turbine to the second stage blades. And then you've got the third stage nozzle, redirecting to the third stage of the turbine. Now in there are the thermocouples. There's one right there. They measure the exhaust gas temperature. And like I said, this particular engine is built up as a J79. This is the rear bearing housing. This is one of the main engine mounts in the aircraft. And this is the afterburner fuel manifold. Four different lines, independently controlled with their lines to the 21 fuel nozzles. This is part of the exhaust nozzle. And this whole thing along here is the jet pipe. It's where the afterburner burns its fuel. There's really not much in there, I'll show you in a second. This is an actuating cylinder which controls the position of the exhaust nozzle. This cooling air always mixes through there. These pedals, this is in the closed position. This is for maximum thrust of the engine without the afterburner. When the afterburner is running, they open up considerably more. And inside here, we actually do have the liner. This protects the outer case from the heat of the fire of the afterburner. And right there at the bottom, at the 6 o'clock position, is the housing for the torch igniter. Torch igniter is what lights the fire, lights the fuel on fire in the afterburner, because as you've seen in other videos, injecting fuel into the hot exhaust of a jet engine will not cause it to burst into flames. And you can see behind the flame holder some very thin pencil-like projections that go all the way from the outside to the inside. Those are the fuel nozzles, which you've seen tested again in another video. And that is a tour from the front to the back of a mocked up J79 with most of the pieces in place. There's not a whole lot missing from this engine. There's a lot of exterior components missing, but the basic core of the engine is all here, and it's very, very similar to what is inside a, well, it's identical actually to what's inside an LM1500. We'll look at the actuating bar and cylinder for the variable stator vanes. It's connected, and it also works the variable intake guide vanes, but these turn in the opposite direction to these. There's two of those, one on that side and one on this side. When we want to start this thing, the starter attaches right there on the gearbox. There's a shaft running inside this strut. There's an angle drive missing from here. It's like half of the rear end of a car. Shaft turns here, turns a gear. Well, this turns, turns a gear, turns a shaft, turns the gearbox. There you go. Now you're an expert on the J79 turbojet engine.